Hey, howdy, hey. Oh my God, where to begin? First of all, I just want to come on here and say that, well, hi, my name is Sarah Beth Banning. I'm a 43-year-old woman. I've already raised 3 kids. My youngest is 19 and at university. Since she went to university in August, I have been floating around trying to figure out, okay, who the heck am I? I've been a mom since I can remember basically anything as far as independent thought goes. Just constantly worried about kids, kids, kids. I had 3 kids. I'm now 43. My kids are all out of the house. What to do with my life? It's really weird to have your evenings, your mornings, to have your life to fill up with you. I know I'm blessed because I am living in a situation where I can now focus on myself. But what the weird part is, from all the trauma of past relationships, the struggles of being a single mom with 3 kids, I'm still dealing with trauma from that. I'm having a hard time feeling safe and established. I have a footing to know I can go from here. All that being said, y'all, I just signed a lease yesterday on a place here in town. It was a pretty good price. I have a friend who I met through teaching at an art school here in town, and our friendship has grown. It turns out she's an excellent picture framer. Oh my God, she is a professional. And since I'm a oil painter extraordinaire, we really connect, and she understands what art needs to look like, and I understand how to make art. Anyways, for a couple years now, we've been talking about opening space, but we weren't at the right. Anyway, we wanted to start something for a couple years, and I just got a wild hair, and I was like, I'm gonna walk over to this like little business park over here. And I saw for lease in the window, and I called up the number, and they had spaces for lease, and then I checked them out, and bam, like a week later, here we are signing a lease, and I'm getting the keys today. I want to take you along on the process of 2 old ladies believing in ourselves, starting out on our art careers again. And yeah, I think it's going to be cool. I have to believe in myself. You know, I watch a lot of creators on YouTube and whatnot, and I'm always rooting for them, and I get disappointed when they don't upload, and I want to see the progress, and I just know that I need to believe in myself now. I really do, and I need to document it for other ladies like me who struggled their whole lives, who were in abusive relationships, who came out of that, who got their degree, who also failed over and over and over again trying to make that degree work. I just need to document this and say it's never too late. Never too late. You're never too old. It's never too far gone. Y'all, the economy's never too bad. I've made so many excuses, but literally it was always me. It was always me not showing up for myself. I know that. We all know that. You know that. I just want to put it out there. I want to document how showing up for myself is gonna work out. Yeah, I believe it's gonna work out, y'all. So, here we go. Okay, just got the keys. So, let me show you the place. I'm gonna turn this around. All right, so, this is the front window. This little side window here, and a big window right here. I'm gonna set up my easel right there starting tomorrow. I ain't wasting no time, y'all.
no time. We're gonna paint the walls a neutral color, like white or something. Yeah, it's right off of a main road. So it's a good location and a good price. So I'm super pumped. Oh, one thing about it, all that has to go. That looks like crap. But I think it looks like crap because it's winter. I believe those are oleanders. Anyway, that needs to be trimmed off, so we're gonna do that.
I can't help but feel like slightly nervous. I don't know why, it's just my modus operandi. I don't wanna be like talking all willy-nilly, but I'm super excited. I'm super excited. So yeah, y'all. It is a start. It isn't that big, but I can come in here and not worry about making the payments. So that is half the battle. I got it, y'all. I got so many paintings to put on these walls already. I can't wait to paint them and hang up my art and just go. Hey, howdy, hey. It's a brand new day, brand new start. I'm heading over to my studio space now. So far in my car, I've got my easel and my chair and a little table to put my paints on. Yeah, I'm gonna drive over there and unlock the doors and start putting my stuff in there. I have to make a couple trips. I'm gonna come back and get my painting I'm working on. The goal is to get set up in there today so I can paint. Maybe I'll paint later today, I don't know. For some reason, it's already hot in Texas. Where are we at, March 7th? I mean, it's a perfect day, it's a beautiful day. But yeah, it's gonna get up to like 85 or something today, so. Crazy since like a few weeks ago we were so cold, but anyways, that's Texas for ya. So anyways, I'm so excited, y'all. I'm just gonna be positive every day. I'm going for my dreams. Gonna be a successful artist. That's the plan. I came up and I vacuumed the studio space. There was a lot of like little wires on the floor for some reason, which was really weird. I hope it didn't ruin my vacuum, but oh well. Floor is vacuumed. Excellent. And yesterday when we got the keys, the landlord gave me and my friend Sarah, she has the same name as me, a little side table.
It's really gross. I need to clean it. I don't have any cleaning supplies here whatsoever. But yeah, temporarily, I put it here. I want to paint the bottom. The top is really nice stained wood, but I just need to clean it. I put it over here by my easel, which is by the window. This, I don't know if I'm going to keep my paints on this board because I want to use the wall space here to display art and art prints and as much wall space in here as possible for my friends' frame samples and for my art and other people's art. So
anyways, I got quite overwhelmed. I don't know what happened. I started bringing stuff in here and my heart rate got really high. I kind of do these panic attack things and then I feel sick. I had to go rest under a blanket in my house. I literally don't know what's wrong with me, but I just know that even though I'm not thinking negative thoughts, my body sometimes overreacts to situations. And in a situation where I'm supposed to be like happy, I was really stressing out and I don't know what that is about. I just don't. Anyway, moving forward, congratulations to myself. I got my artwork over here. I didn't paint today, but I'm gonna go back to my house and maybe grab a rug. I have some pretty rugs and bring it back over and a cleaning thing, like something to clean my side table with. Y'all, I'm feeling better and I grabbed my rug. We're gonna put that in there. Isn't it beautiful? Wait, just wait, I'll show you. All right, I got this cute rug in here for my painting area, so I like it a lot. It's pretty cool, pretty cool. Temporarily. Let's put this back up here.
Y'all, I love it with the lights off. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna set my chair. I can sit here and paint. Here's my paints, all can be stored right here in this hand-me-down side table. Look at this giant floor to ceiling and God bless America, y'all. God bless America. God bless Texas.
Okay, y'all, I'm journaling today. I'm gonna start painting. It's weird, I haven't journaled in here for over a year. Jeez, my last entry was January 13th, 2022, which was my son's birthday over a year ago. So here we go, journaling. Then, I'm gonna start painting. I'm gonna try. My daughter's gonna come see me real quick first. Well, unfortunately, I did not video very much yesterday. But anyways, starting over today, oh look, I made my bed. Epic baby steps. Anyway, so outfit check, got my little sneakers on because I'm gonna walk to my studio today. I need the exercise and I need the sunshine. So trying to make good decisions. Here we go. One of the things I envisioned when I thought about renting this space was, hey, I could walk there. It's like literally right down the road. So yeah, so if I thought about it and I don't do it, that's just me being fearful. So I'm gonna walk over there. I got a backpack on. It's so cute. So yeah, I'm going. Oh, it's a beautiful day outside. Oh my goodness, isn't it gorgeous? So exciting. Well, I'm gonna let you go so the neighbors don't think I'm crazy talking to my phone. Okay, bye y'all.
Okay, well I made it up here. I turned on the light today because
I don't care who sees me. Honestly, what is my problem? LOL. So yeah, I'm gonna get started painting. Okay, so me and my friend are at City Hall filling out appropriate paperwork for our businesses. So this is exciting. And we just went and picked up the paint. So we gotta paint all the walls white. Eek! Yes, I am. Get out the roast, the pot roast picnic. Has anyone had a pot roast picnic? We're having a pot roast picnic.
Delicious.
Green beans. Mashed taters. And the pot roast. Yes, what do you know about it? Nothing, because we invented the pot roast picnic. Okay. Is there a bug? The Martins are quite upset that we're having a pot roast picnic. But the bugs love it.
Okay, thank you.
So fun.
Just the piece.
Yay. Can you see it? I don't even know what I'm filming right now. Is the sun over there somewhere?
Yes.
I can't see. No! Okay. Frame y'all up here.
I can see you. Right now? After all the poppers?
Yeah.
The sun, oh my god.
The sun is disappearing.
What
I'm doing yoga.
Sun salutations.
Nina,
oh, Nina the yogi. Oh, look at it go. Amazing. Wait, hold on.
Hola.
Moon child, show your moon childness.
I'll pass it with
Alright, so it is March 23rd. Today I'm in my studio, writing in my journal currently. So that's pretty cool. I've already spent like an hour painting, and my painting is outside the window drying because it's very stinky. I used Galkit on it to help just put a thin coat to dry quickly, and yeah, that needs to sit outside for a little bit. So I'm very happy I made progress. I have got all the walls painted except for the little area around the boards that are gonna hold the other Sarah's frame samples, because this is also gonna be a frame shop. So there's an area on that side of the room that I have to I think she'll cut in around her frame wall of frame samples after she puts trim around her giant boards that are gonna hold the frame samples. So yeah, hopefully that can get going. I just wanna talk about how much I struggled the past week or two, and I think a lot of people struggle with the same things that I struggle with. Just a lot of anxiety, feeling like, what am I doing? Why am I renting a space? I'm not going to be able to make money to even cover it. Just feelings of inadequacy and not believing in myself. And the funny thing is if I just push those thoughts out of my head and just go forward, I usually do pretty well. Of course, I always doubt myself through the process. Like, even just coming here and painting this room, I doubted myself, but I got it done. The walls are white. It's actually called chalk, but you know. And right now, like with this painting out here, I'm like really struggling. I'm like, what am I doing? This material feels weird to paint on. It's very like, I don't know. It's just different than a canvas. I'm used to painting on canvas. And I'm worried, did I seal it enough? Is that the problem? But I did put two coats of clear primer on it. And then the main part I'm painting is the deer. And the deer, I also put a coat of white gesso on it. So it's got like two coats of clear gesso and one coat of white gesso on the main part I'm painting. So that's like three coats. But you never know. Everything's like, I don't know. I've never done this but one other time. And that turned out pretty well. I don't know if you can see that.
Yeah, so that one turned out awesomely. I even just varnished it. Looking pretty good.
Yes.
But yeah, how funny. I wonder what people think driving by and there's a big canvas just leaning against this window. You know what? They probably don't think anything. So yeah, I think right now I'm gonna finish writing in my journal and then I'm gonna do something cool. I'm gonna start preparing this journal, this old planner, sorry, that was never used. It was my boyfriend's planner and he never used it. So I'm gonna turn this into like an artistic journal where I can just do whatever I want in here. And it does not matter what it looks like, because I need something that I can do where it just does not matter what it looks like, because we're already starting off with an outdated planner. But this is so cool feeling. It's a shame to waste, so I want to upcycle this, recycle. Anyway, this has a totally different vibe for me creatively than doing something like this. Totally. So I'm gonna get started on that. See if I enjoy it. So I'm like always telling myself, oh yeah, you can see it out the window there. I was painting and I was like, oh my God, it smells so bad in here. And I got neighbors and I don't want them smelling it, so. Isn't that cool how you can see the flowers through the deer? Oh my God, that's so epic. I love it. So yeah, in the middle of this painting, I am seriously doubting what I'm doing because the colors aren't natural to like the deer's actual colors. I'm modifying the colors to make it blend more with the material. So there's a lot of gray in there, very little reddish brown, very little purplish brown. And if I put too much reddish brown or too much purplish brown, you can really tell. But I don't want to just straight up gray. So it's like a fine dance I'm doing. And it's just very, I don't know. It's very weird. I have a mission. I'm going through it in thin layers to build up the deer. Because I don't want the deer to be too powerful, too strikingly opposed to the background. I just want it all to work together. So we'll see how that goes. Oh, what cute little ducks. Mm-hmm. Oh, there goes another duck. Thanks.
was going to write in my journal. Hold on, let me go find it.
Okay.
Well, apparently I left my journal at the studio and I can't go to the studio right now because it's raining. And my transmission on my car is going out. So I don't even have a car. So I have to wait for my boyfriend to get off his meeting to drive me down there. It's okay. I'm gonna do a little sketchy. My drawing journal. New page. Maybe I'll sketch something out this window, but I just wanted to come on here and talk about how I have this like vision for my life and all these really great ideas on what my life could be and where it could go and my art career and the just in general, like how I want to live as a person. And I'm not gonna get there if I'm not disciplined. So I wanna start every day with writing my dreams and my plans for the day and envisioning the day I want it to go, and then try to live the day I envision. And also about once a week, I was thinking I would plan my week and how it would go, what I want to get accomplished for that whole week. Anyways, this is an ongoing process, and yeah, I just wanted to document it. Let's see what happens. Okay, hi. I just want to come on here and say that I really haven't been successful with journaling every day, but that's okay. Because at this moment, I am making this video. I've done a lot of different various art projects. My studio space is still not done, but that's mainly because my studio partner is still moving in her stuff, and I'm kind of gave her some space over the last few days to get all set up, and it's cool. She's making a lot of progress, and she's even done some framing in there. Anyways, this is me having breakfast and writing in my journal, which even if I don't get to do it every day, I'm proud I do it most days, and I'm so proud I'm making this video right now. I went outside and I cleaned our patio table. That thing hadn't been cleaned in years. And I brought my sketch journal, and it was a beautiful day. Many, many, many butterflies, many flowers, some good sun, and I was feeling pretty good about myself, honestly, at this point in time. And I think it's cool that I documented that. I think it's nice to look back at your life and remember the happy times. It makes me feel good to see this sunshiny day where I did nothing more than sketch that bird feeder right there, but it was awesome and it's a good memory.
Gibson J45, y'all. What's up?
Beautiful.
Can hear the music. We're on the Lano River. There's Justin over there. I have to check that out. Music and art. It's such a perfect day in Texas.
So me and Justin drove out to Lano, and apparently they're having a festival. Get that. It must be like 70 degrees right now. Not a cloud in the sky. It's perfect.
And I'm way up here on this rock, about 8 feet off the ground. There's a giant oak tree right in front of me. So cool. Giant boulders coming up out of the earth. How cool is that? Pretty cool.
That's just literally growing over this rock here.
Texas Hill Country. Killing the game.
Blue bonnets were everywhere on the drive.
It was beautiful.
The weather's perfect too.
Hey, howdy, hey y'all. Yesterday I found a picture frame when I was in Lano at an antique store for $20, and I'm gonna gold leaf it for my Deer and Roses painting, so I'm gonna show you.
Okay, so here it is. I love the ornateness of it. It's very like romantic in style, just like that deer painting in the roses. So I'm gonna go leaf it, but first I'm going to go hang out with Angelina and we're gonna find some blue bonnets for some photo ops. So, and if you're wondering why I'm out of breath, it's because I just sanded this picture frame and then, I don't know, it's hot in here. I just turned on the AC, but I'm kind of sweating because it's a warm one today. Anyway.
Hi, Angelina. What are we doing today?
Pictures and the blue bonnet.
Wearing our Texas get up, y'all. Because we're Texas girls. Ain't that right?
Show us those boots.
I don't know if you can see them, but yeah, there's a lot of blue bonnets. Anyway, this beautiful,
I can't talk.
Oak tree is giving us shade. It's magnificent. Right, Angie?
Mm-hmm. Nice outside.
We're gonna take some more pictures in a minute, but yeah, just resting from the heat. Texas man.
Thanks for getting the tree off my forehead. Say hi.
Hello.
We're just sitting in the shade at the park.
Smelling the flowers.
Those blue bonnets smell crazy. Angie's headed out right now to do some selfies in the middle of the blue bonnets.
A little windier. Oh my god. The perfect day.
This is called Arrowhead Park in beautiful Lago Vista. And this is called the most epic oak tree. I love it.
What? It looks like Texas? Epic. Epicness.
No, it was surprisingly difficult to walk over all these rocks
to get to the water, and we're still pretty far because the lake went down and the water level is really low. And oh my god, don't fall off.
Where's the cliff?
Yeah,
there's the cliff.
Well,
It's hard to walk in boots on rocks, but you know, getting practice. So scatty.
Oh my god, so cool though.
Wow. Yeah, we ain't climbing down there, that's for sure.
Is this rock sturdy?
Yeah.
It
looks. Totally. Well. Oh, and just look at all this blue bonnets.
So pretty.
And I'm back from the park. That was fun. Here you see me applying the gold leaf adhesive, and it's very thin and runny, as you can see here, like milk. It goes on thin, but then it gets tacky. When it's tacky, after 30 minutes, you can apply the gold leaf. And anyone who's worked with gold leaf knows gold leafing is very difficult. And especially when you're working on a bumpy surface, it doesn't cover solidly first go round, as you can see. I go back in here and just try to patch up where I can. And even when I finish patching up, I still have more patching up to do, but I will finish. It's going to look phenomenal. It's going to look stunning around my Deer and Roses painting. I'm so excited. I can't wait to show y'all. So please watch again next week. If you like this video and you lasted till this point, please like and subscribe. I'm going to try to post regularly. So yeah, it was great. I should say it was awesome being able to do this video and finally get it out there. Y'all have a good day. Bye.